what was happening to my left and in the valley. Suddenly the tarpaulin blew away from its moorings. I looked down the valley and saw scores, if not hundreds, of tanks lined up, German tanks of course, ready to invade Poland.
Mainly known for being the author of what is considered the scoop of the century, Clare Hollingworth can be considered as one of the most important journalists. She constantly challenged herself and redefined the role of a war reporter.
Living next to Lester in wartime had a strong impact on her future career. On 31st December 1915, when a German Zeppelin passed over Shepshed village, she found herself closer to war action than most English kids. The traumatic experience triggered her passion towards warfare, leading her to visit battlefields often.
I enjoy action. I enjoy being in a plane that's bombing something, or being on the ground in the desert when they're advancing.
3 days before the official outbreak of World War II, Clare witnessed the German tanks and soldiers preparing to attack Poland. She described the moment in one of her interviews.
And I was on the German-Polish frontier when the German hordes, tanks, moved in.
3 days later, on the 1st of September, the tanks rolled in. And I remember telephoning to Robin Hankey. And I put the telephone out of the window so he could hear the tanks rolling in.
The story she wrote about the event became the scoop of the century, and it was featured on the first page of the Daily Telegraph.
The three towns I visited are completely dead so far as the civil population is concerned. Streets, shops and cafes, all are deserted.
Clare was not only a great writer, but also fought for gender equality, facing many obstacles, including challenging the practice that banned women from reporting during the war. At first, she followed the British Army in Cairo, but when she was banned by General Montgomery, she did not give up and decided to join the American troops. Thus, by reporting on the British North African campaign in 1941, she blazed a trail for future generations of women correspondents.
Apart from the Second World War, she also reported from Egypt about El Alamein and other countries including Vietnam, Greece, Romania, as well as the Algerian Civil War and the Chinese Cultural Revolution. Her stellar career was accompanied by many awards. This includes the Hannah Swaffer Award for Woman Journalist of the Year and was acknowledged by the Queen in the form of the Order of the British Empire for services to journalism in 1982.
She was fearless, a true seeker, who loved being near the action. She was not afraid to pursue the story she was after, even if that meant sleeping on the floor. She was also a humanitarian who saved countless lives. People all over the world were inspired by her bravery and her outstanding perseverance.
Former Hong Kong Governor Chris Patten said, "Clare was quite literally one of the greatest journalists of the 21st century. She was a great buccaneer, brave, witty and wise. She covered some of the greatest stories of the last century with imitable dash and, on top of all that, she was kind and lovable."
"Passionately interested in war, and if one is passionately interested in war, one can't help like being in it."
She is our journalism idol because, as put into words by veteran BBC war correspondent Kate Addy, she was a role model without being aware of it, in the sense that she loved the job and had a terrific zest for journalism right to the end of her life.